Bila sam nedavno u Beču i posetila božanstven izložbeni prostor Belvedere, gde sam se srela sa umetničkim predmetima koje je dr. Vile preneo na nakit. I žela sam to da zabeležim i da to vidite.
Zamak Belveder. U njemu je živeo Evgenij od Savoje. I to je bila njegova letnja rezidencija. Kada je vrućina u Beču, kao što je danas jako velika vrućina, onda je živeo ovde. Unutra je prijatno i lepo. I danas je tu muzej. I tu se nalaze svi umetnički predmeti vezani čak i za srednji vek pa do današnjih dana koji su značajni za Austriju. A tamo dole, što vidite, to je Donji Belveder. Tu se uvek nalazi jedna ekskluzivna i izložba koja je vezana ne za stalnu postavku, ali su to izložbe koje su od izuzetnog značaja i koje se menjaju. Sa posebnom dozvolom ušli smo i mi da pogledamo neke slike. To je slika Klimta. Pred njom se okupljaju ljudi na isti način kao ispred Monalize u Luvru. Imamo sreću da nema mnogo ljudi. Poljubac. Mnogi naravno ovde dolaze samo zbog Klimta. I ovo je prepoznatljivi Klimt. Ulje i zlato na platnu. Kao da je predosećao da će njegove slike biti jednog dana na nakitu. I da vam kažemo zašto smo došli. Priča je sledeća. Kada vi u biznis unesete ideju i ta ideja nađe plodno tlo, onda možete da kažete da u svom poslu i u svom biznisu imate vizije. Gospodin koga intervjuišem je upravo to. It's a mission.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yes.
Because if you put in a way the best painters of Austria on your jewelry, this is a national mission for Austria.
I'm sure because we are worldwide, we are unique. And you will see several things which come from Austria only. Only, yes. Of course, we are very proud that Klimt was a Viennese. He had a fantastic idea. Klimt is the pope of the kind of art what we are doing, decorative art.
You're known as Frey Wille. Mm-hmm. Who is Frey?
Frey is the founder of the company almost 60 years ago. And Wille is me.
Wille is you?
Yes. Wille
so
is me.
Combined.
We have combined it because at the beginning, during about 30 years, we were well known under the name of Michaela Frey. But when she died in more than 30 years ago, then it was not possible, it was not reasonable even to cut off all the different...
You know what is interesting? The people usually, they like to cut off. And they think when they start something, that nothing ever was before them. Yeah, and it's so nice to keep the tradition and to make this connection, really.
I agree with you completely because not everybody is my opinion. But I think that this is only just to the founder of the company. She was an artist and she suffered very much under the burden of having to create something in a certain time all the time. So she was one of the artists who really broke down under the enormous burden of a must, a time limit. Since then, since 1980, I could organize a completely new philosophy where we had always more than 10 artists in the company who had time and no pressure. You cannot imagine.
Can you repeat that? Can you repeat that? It is going to be so useful for all the artists and creative people. Because, you know, if you put the pressure, The creativity stops.
This is the point. If then you are only suffering, you can be creative. Like Yves Saint Laurent, I knew him personally because we worked with him a little bit together. So I met him when I worked together with him in Paris. And that's why he was under a terrible burden. A time limit was a burden for him enormously. Of course, he then created something. But after a certain time, you cannot really carry on like that. You have to give up, or you take drugs or whatever. This is a terrible thing. I really believe this is one of my own responsibilities. I am the owner of the company. When I invite people to work in the company, I always want to care for them. So for me, it's not. It's very important that they feel good, that they feel happy, they are happy, and. Of the side aspect is, of course, that the efficiency is much bigger. If somebody feels happy what he is doing, then what comes out is much more important, and especially in creations like this.